We're here in chilly and Dickus Springs, Colorado, where the air is thin and the smoke is thick. It's Pop Brownie Day here at sold-out Noah Thorny Field. And the crowd is fired up for some football after an intense pregame screening of 2001 A Space Odyssey. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers and lots of beers. The Malice Hellboys take on the Mile High Chronic. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's a beautiful day for MFL football. At least in the booth with the AC, personal servants, and blood shield. Hi, Grim Blitzrow here with you, along with my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing that little hottie who works the deep fry at the concessions.
He said how, not who, you idiot. Even if you got the answer right.
And it's first and ten. Running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. And it's first and ten. And there's an 8-yard catch.
Chipping away with those medium passes. I like it. Like a patient prison break.
Second down and two. And it's first and ten. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Second down and ten. He's not going down. That pass was good for 10 yards. Third down and a sliver. Picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Ma, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. He picks up 9 yards on that catch. And that'll bring bring up second and one. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And it's first and ten. He picks up a two. And that'll be second and eight to go. First and ten.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
First and two. Burners after that catch and score. Nicely done. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten.
Balls in the past.
The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. They're back up here on first, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile. And they stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
First down.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
And it's first and ten.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot.
Oh, with the brain scrambler. Second and three.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot.
And the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick. Man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
first and 10. You can tell he's a berserker because he's boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of one. And it's first and 10. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
Rumbles for 9 on that play. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. 3rd and 2. Defense better look out. The offense called the Beast Boost Dirty Trick. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkey skin planted on his backside from that band Bernie in last year.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's 1st and 10. And he picks up about 6 on the play. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. If he is getting killed by a chainsaw, it's first and 10. Nice pass. That catch is good for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4. MFL, because whatever they juice that player with to make him run that fast can't be legal. Third down and long. That's a pass and catch for no gain.
Then how is it a pass?
For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Second down and 2. That's a catch for a 1 yard gain. That's not going to do it, fellas. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. That was a good throw, assuming he was aiming for the ground. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And the punter has one job to do, and that's punt the ball. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball is down.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one.
Oh, man, he just crushed him. I gotta see that again.
I had a kid once like that walking down the sidewalk texting with his earbuds in. Freaked him out. He said, hey, what'd you do that for? I said, to teach you a lesson. What lesson? He said, that unless you're a baboon with big baboon balls, you gotta pay attention. Yeah, along the jungle, you know?
The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grin.
2nd down and a lot. And then to 1st down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
The QB saves some clock by calling a timeout. They have 1 left. And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game.
Hot.
And he held on to that one for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. That's it. That's their last time out. It's them against the other team and the clock.
Well, that doesn't seem fair. I'm going to throw a hammer.
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. Oh, and that one's going to hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. Man, what a hit that was. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
I don't understand me, dude.
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a...
Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. He rifled that one in there, and they come up with 10 yards on the play. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And that is caught for a first down. First down and 5. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he made...
Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and 5. Third down and 8. He had it for a second there.
Oh,
punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. Nice catch, and that, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. Which will slice its way through any defensive player trying, and he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. And the QB might as well just bury himself now, because this guy's, oh man, Bricks, you've got to love a player who goes down fighting. And the offense averts disaster by recovering the fumble. 4 yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Third down and 6.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot, hot, hot.
First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and 10. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and 9. Nicely done for a first down. Now these guys need to talk to the ref about those calls, and by talk I mean stomp him into the ground. Second down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Third down, and never going to happen. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly fast. Through the defense on that play and picks up a nice chunk of yardage. Now this one's gonna be tough. I hope he has a good enough leg for this one.
I saw him try one on before the game. He looked okay, I think. Not my type though, a little too mutilated.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10.
Hot, hot one, hot two, hot, 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 hot.
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. Quarter comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit. And it's first and ten. They call the warp speed dirty trick. He's done. And the running game is starting to click now. A pickup of eight on the play. Second down and two. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown!
Take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy. And, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And he just slipped away like a greased pig. And he picks up maybe four on that play. It's first and ten. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Picked up a lot of real estate in a hurry. Give him 10 yards right there. Second down and inches. And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown! And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Totally uncalled for, and that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and ten. When the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
And a hard run there picks up the first down. And it's first and ten. Great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and ten. Gets your motor running. It's chainsaw time. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. Receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and 10.
Hey, guys, this isn't funny. I swear to drunk, I'm not God, but seriously, stay in drugs, eat school, and don't do vegetable.
And that's a run for no gain. Third down and 10. 2 minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back. After I top off my drink.
When did they do that?
Third down and 10. Oh, nice hit. And they quickly call a timeout to stop the clock. And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Nice pickup for 6 yards. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, with the punishing hit. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
You've got to catch that. Quarterback didn't like that last play, so he decided to undo it with a time warp dirty trick.
I don't trust quarterbacks with that kind of power. First it's plays, what's next? Bribe a ref, then take your money back. Data model, then take your money back. It's a slippery slope, Grim.
Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown!
Eh, big deal. Mr. Meat for Brain grabbing a ball and didn't fall down.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Oh, what a brutal hit! And it's first and 10. Well, that's two timeouts burned. And you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
Yeah, I'm speaking from experience, Grim. But it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
Oh, he just got crushed. And it's first. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just...
The Chronic is defeated today. The opposition came into town and stole one from them. It's a bitter one-point loss.
Just like a thief in the night. They should go to jail. Stealing ain't right, Grim.
Let's listen to what the game's most valuable player has to say about it.
Why? The guy's got the intelligence of a horseshoe.
Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.